Hello friends, today we'll look into the top 10 tips on increasing flowering in hibiscus plant and maintain the blooms all year round. These 10 tips are really easy to follow and watch all the 10 tips till the end. Plus, there is a bonus surprise hack at the end of the video. Stay tuned. If you are a hobby gardener or you have interest in growing plants in your home garden, please consider subscribing to this channel with the notification bell icon clicked so that you receive notifications whenever I upload a new video. Hibiscus or hibiscus plants have gorgeous flowers that can make any garden look spectacular. The flowers are bright and colorful with different colors like the red, yellow, pink and white. Remember, the only way to make your hibiscus produce flowers is to keep it happy and stress-free. And this is really not a difficult task. And with very little efforts like following these 10 tips, you can keep it blooming every day throughout the year, and it is actually possible. Tip number 10, repotting. This is the first job you do when you bring your hibiscus plant from a nursery or a garden store. This is the most important step because you need to mix few important ingredients into the soil during repotting. And these things you will learn further as we go on with the other tips till the end. Tip number 9, the container size. The concept here is if you choose a deep container, it will focus more on root development and less on flower production. The best one is a container that is wider than the usual nursery pot, but still not too deep. This way you make your hibiscus strong and make it produce more flowers. Then tip number 8 is the location. The hibiscus plant should be grown in areas of the garden that are situated away from traffic and pollution, and also in a location that is not disturbed by frequent movements from people and animals or even your pets. Best places with plenty of sunlight are the patios, balconies and terrace. Then tip number 7 is soil. Hibiscus prefers a slightly acidic soil and a soil rich in organic matter. You can use the well-draining universal potting soil plus add few extra ingredients that will be summarized at the end of the video. Please watch my separate video on the universal potting soil and potting mix after you finish this video from the end screen links. Anyways, during repotting add additional 10% compost like decomposed cow dung or horse dung or even vermicompost. For making it acidic, if you have a soil pH tester, it's really good. Otherwise, you can water it weekly with about 5 to 10 ml vinegar solution mixed in 1 liter of water. Then tip number 6 is the fertilizer. It's just a flowering plant. You can use both inorganic as well as organic fertilizers for this plant. You have to follow a cycle of alternate use of NPK and DAP crystals every 15 days. You can use NPK 20-20-20 crystals, about 5 to 6 crystals or about 10 smaller crystals into a 12-inch pot. And then the next 15 days you can use the DAP crystals about the same quantity. You can watch my detailed video on NPK crystals at the end of the video from the end screen links. If you do not have NPK, you can also use decomposed horse dung or cow dung powder on the top layer of the soil once every month after raking the soil. Then the tip number 5 is raking the soil, that is soil raking. This is an important step before applying any fertilizer or manure to your plant. Raking the soil is recommended once every 15 days. Make it a habit to rake the soil and then apply your fertilizer. Then tip number 4 is watering. If you are growing in containers, daily watering is must, and do not worry about overwatering if you are using a well-drained soil. If it is planted in ground, watering twice weekly is sufficient. And tip number 3 is sunlight. Place your plant in a location where you get adequate sunlight. At least 6 hours to 8 hours of direct sunlight is compulsory for hibiscus. Then tip number 2, pruning. Pruning hibiscus from time to time is essential for maintaining blooms in hibiscus. Remove any dead or unhealthy looking branches. You can also prune those branches which do not have buds or which have already produced flowers. Then finally, the tip number 1 is pest control. The most important factor according to me to keep the plant healthy and blooming is control the pests. Examine the plant closely for pests and insects including the underside of the leaves. Common pests like whiteflies, aphids, mealybugs, etc. can be easily eliminated using neem oil spray alone or a mix of neem oil spray plus liquid soap in water. I have a detailed video on this topic on 5 ways to eliminate aphids, mealybugs and whiteflies. Please follow this from the card at the top right corner of the video or at the end screen. But first let's complete the video. Now finally, a simple hack which is a nursery secret. I have already disclosed this in one of my video called Bone in Gardening. Once I incidentally found a small piece of long bone during repotting hibiscus pot from a nursery store. So this hack perhaps keeps releasing the element phosphorus into the soil for producing good blooms in these plants. So you can either do this or use the steamed bone meal powder easily available at garden stores or even online. Mix 1 teaspoon of bone meal powder into the soil during repotting. So there we have it folks, those were the top 10 tips to increase flowering or boosting your hibiscus blooms. If you like the tips, please give a like to the video by clicking the thumbs up below the video. And also, if you have some more tips, please share them in the comment section below the video, including your suggestions. Your comments and likes are really important for me, and this encourages me to produce more videos like these. Then also consider subscribing to the channel if you're new to the channel. Happy gardening!